The minister has just started reading out the budget speech. What's your quick take on today's budget? What do you expect quickly?
I think it should be a growth-oriented budget, which should really address the economy, which is in a shambles right now, because everything is hinging to that. Unless we make major corrections in spurring the demand and bringing the money back into the market, things would not.
Bringing back money and demand creation, that's the key.
So I think government needs to see that how the consumption should be revived in the market, right? We are struggling from last 2 years in the auto industry. So when we can able to revive the consumption, I think that is the way it's look forward.
Consumption, what's your take? You are a dealer.
Consumption has to be increased. Without increasing the consumption and demand, nothing can be improved.
So electric vehicle is the new baby in the block. You represent electric vehicle. What's your special request from the minister?
So the key areas would be definitely lithium ion battery is an important aspect of electric vehicle. And GST on lithium ion currently is 18%. It should be reduced to 5% so that it is at par with the electric vehicle, right?
Manav, you are a component maker, mid-sized component maker. What is your expectation from the minister?
For the auto components segment, what we've seen is there's a mixed GST rate from 18% to 18%. So we request the industry industry request to have a flat 18% GST rate for the entire component industry. And we are looking for some liquidity as well, because a lot of control on the banks releasing loans for mid-sized companies.
So those were the key demands that the industry expects from the Union Finance Minister. She has just started reading the speech. We'll join you after the budget speech, and these experts are going to be with us at ETAuto. There were certainly great expectations, but how much the Finance Minister has lived up to the expectation? We have an expert panel to discuss on this. Let me introduce to you Mr. Gaurav Vangaal, who is industry head at IHS Market, Mr. Arvind Saxena, who is former MD and C president of General Motors and an industry veteran. We have Mr. Amit Garg, who is owner of Shiva Motor Corp, one of the largest dealers for luxury and mass segment vehicles. We have Mr. Lohia, Ayush Lohia, who is a manufacturer of electric vehicle. We also have Mr. Avik Sarkar, who is of ISB a person, and he has been in NITI Aayog also. We also have a political commentator and an author here who will also giving you the importance of this budget on Indian society, economy and polity. So let's begin with you, Mr. Saxena. How do you see the current scenario? Are you really hopeful? Are you expecting any kind of change? What we were yesterday, how do you see today's turning out to be for automotive industry?
For automotive industry, I really don't see any change happening, truly. Though there were major issues which one was expecting, that you know this should spur a consumption and should spur demand in the market, I think it doesn't really address it very, very directly. Though there is some things on the agriculture side, I think there's a huge outlay which is supporting the agriculture. Maybe in some way it could support the rural market. But I think there is no direct support for automotive, except for certain, maybe on a component side, where some outlay has been given for technological upgradation. To some extent, I think that's the only positive. But overall, I would say it is not positive for automotive.
So similar, you know, sense prevails among the auto industry honchos. I got few comments from the industry leaders. I just put it like this. One of the leaders at former Hero Motor Corp, Mr. Ashok Bhasin, says that despite an acute need on multiple fronts in the economy, today's budget is missing on big, bold steps. Ashok Bhasin was leading sales and marketing at Hero Motor Corp. Mr. Hardeep Goindi, he says that overall, no clear direction, all over the place, incremental approach, lots of rhetoric, too long speech. Certainly, it was one of the longest speech ever delivered by a finance minister. Gaurav, you are a market watcher, especially automotive space. How do you interpret the budget today?
See, I will interpret into the two things first. First is that there is no direct benefit given to us. The second, which was a kind of a disappointment for auto industry because we were waiting for some kind of relief from the finance minister. The second is the indirect benefits. Now, indirect benefits are partially given to the long term, not at the short term. So, consumption revival, which has been given only for the in the side of the personal tax, which is again a debatable term right now because the standard deductions and the deductions you need to leave. That's what need to be accessed first. Then the positive side, but it's in the long term. The farming focus has been shown to us. Domestic electronic market, which are thinking that electronic component should be invested and specifically name taken for the semiconductor packaging. Now this needs to be seen as the connected cars and the electric vehicles are the focus for the market going forward, right? And the infrastructure focus was also there when we have heard from the finance minister that 9,000 kilometer of economic corridor, 2,000 kilometer of the coastal roads. Now this is going to benefit the commercial vehicle, but these all are at the long term or the near term. But right now, just to spur the demand, I think something was missing here.
Nothing to be almost happy for the automotive industry. I just got a message from Vinkesh Gulati, who is Federation of Automobile Dealers Association's Vice President. He says new DDT to be taxed at the hands of receipts recipients at applicable rates only. This is not a good announcement. While Winnie Mehta from ACMA, he says that turnover threshold for audit for MSME increased from rupees 1 crore to rupees 5 crore. This will enhance ease of doing business. I have here with me Mr. Amit Garg. Amit, you know, dealership community is one of the worst hit because of the capital cost, the kind of inventory you had. How do you see this budget? Do you think, because there is a biggest challenge of demand creation, consumption improvement, do you think it is going to help on these two crucial fronts?
I don't see any direct demand creation from this budget. But yes, a lot of funds are allocated in agriculture segment, in infrastructure segment. So in times to come, demand can be increased or generated. But for short term demand creation, I just can't see any demand creation is there. So the situation is almost same.
Is there something for you in EV space?
So no change as far as what we foresee from the retail finance front or the GST front. Nothing has been spoken about. Definitely, we haven't seen any change from what is there yesterday and what is there today. So no change.
So almost no change looks like. Mr. Sarkar, you track technology very closely. You know that automobile is becoming a hub for technology with connected coming up, with digitization taking place. How do you see today's budget when it comes to improving technology at automobile level, looking at safety, looking at the connectivity, looking at the digital gadgets that is going to be used in cars going forward?
So yes, that's correct what the other people are saying. There is not anything directly for the automotive sector, other than if you look at the large infrastructure announcement that are made, the Delhi-Mumbai corridor and the Bangalore-Chennai corridor, which the work will start. This will spurge a lot of demand in the transport and automobile sector. But I was really happy to see the mention of emerging technologies like analytics, artificial intelligence, robotics been mentioned about several times. I think more than 5 or 6 times the finance minister mentioned about them. These are technologies which have huge impact on every sector, and with cars becoming more digital in nature, it can improve the functioning of the cars. The whole manufacturing operations can become sleeker and can save in operational efficiency. So there is a lot of hope. This directions also, there was a clear message that the private sector has to pick up this stuff and work with the corporates, the automobile manufacturers to get the benefits.
Shantanu, I have a different question for you. We have seen that 5% GDP growth, that's what we estimate for this financial year. How do you see this? How do you see this kind of socio-economic condition right now?
I think the headline from this budget will happen when all the newspapers, I think, including ET and Times Now and Times of India tomorrow, will be the major income tax cut for the salaried class. And that will also fuel consumption. I disagree with a couple of panelists. I think it will also have an increase in demand for the auto sector because there's some savings of the order of 70 to 80,000. This will also fuel the auto industry demand. I think yesterday.
But that exemption or that tax benefit is optional. You can either, go for the earlier exemptions that were in ATD, ATD, ATC, ATD and others. So how do you think there is going to be any major, liquidity at the hands of people?
I surely think so. And also I remember an editorial by Mr. Rajiv Bajaj, I think 3 months back in Times of India, where he said that auto industry should not keep looking for sops from the government. Auto industry should also work on the competitiveness. I think yesterday we saw a profit reported by Tata and Hero Motors. And it's only largely based on the export. So I think African market is open. If we are competitive technology-wise, there is market open. We always not keep looking for the SOPs. I think if we want to compete with China, we have to work on technology or on efficiency also.
I'll come back to you, Mr. Saxena. How do you see the fiscal cliff that is being talked about, 3.8%? How do you look at this? Do you think it is reasonable?
No, I think in a current situation, when we have seen the last year going by at about 3.8, frankly targeting at 3.5 in a situation where we are today, I would think that we should allow fiscal deficit to go down a little bit more to get more money for improving the condition of the industry. I mean, it is not a support only for industry, but it also will support the economy.
Do you think the current plan to divest LIC, Life Insurance Corporation, do you think it will give some kind of strength to the government in terms of having cash at hand or...
I'm not sure because that has already been taken into account. But unless we really bring in money to spur demand and consumption, I think my first point which I made, and that can only happen when we put money into the market. And unless that is done, I think it would not make a significant impact. It will improve in a due course of time, but it would be too long.
So obviously, two major point that is being raised here is demand and consumption improvement. That's the key. Two-wheeler is one area. We have seen a lot of focus on rural economy. How do you see this budget? Do you think any kind of demand coming back in two-wheeler space? Because two-wheeler sales has also been negative.
I think, Nabeel, we have just talked about that personal income tax thing, right? If we are getting some benefit, because every individual has to analyze their own income tax benefits from it. If they're getting some benefits, yes, definitely it's going to help the two-wheeler industry. Because for two-wheeler industry, 30,000, 20,000 rupees, if you are saving, then definitely it's a major chunk. You can go out and buy your two-wheeler then.
Let's come back to you, Shantanu. Job crisis is one of the another bigger reason that we have right now in our economy. Do you think today's budget speech has something that could spur job creation in India?
I think from last 5 years, one interesting thing we are hearing is ease of doing business. I think we have to come out with the mindset that government is the my bap and they will provide all the jobs. Government can only create the infrastructure to so that new companies can come up. And we have seen how corporate tax was removed a couple of months back. And today, again, the focus was on ease of doing business. If you see Chief Economic Advisor's amazing videos that he made and posted yesterday, his focus was on ease of doing business. And I think we should commend Chief Economic Advisor that how sportily he came and made those videos with commenting on Shruti Kakkad of Band Baja Bharat and Dhoni. And so that's a very...
Trying to connect to the people. But if you talk about corporate tax, like personal tax today, similar kind of thing was there. If you forego all the other benefits, then only you get the corporate tax advantage. And at a time when your real problem is demand and consumption, you are propelling further expansion or setting up a new unit. How much does it work in an economy which is really dealing with low demand?
See, I'm saying that the personal tax exemptions that we've seen, a lot of people will avail that and the consumption will increase. The government have to make a balance between its revenue, and we have seen GST collections are low. So they can't put everything on income tax also. They have to run, as he said, the caring society, a lot of welfare schemes also. So it's a tough job for us, we sitting in industry. But I'll point out that industry should also not keeping looking for shops, should work on their exports and their efficiency. African market, China is selling big time there. If efficiency is increased, there are huge motor market available in Africa.
So I'll just come to you. How do you see that Shantanu says that we need to focus on enhancing our own prowess in terms of exporting Make in India?
No, I'm sure that's one of the ways, and this is what been happening for the last, 10 to 15 years in this industry. Not that it has not been happening, but it works well as long as you have a good high consumption in the country. You can't simply make an export-oriented business. Automobile especially is a volume-based business. And export, in addition to the domestic consumption, gives you a good cost efficiencies. And that is how you can use it. You can't simply base your business entirely on export.
Yes, you have to a mix of domestic and exports. Yeah, you want to add?
I just want to add something on the jobs front. There is a lot of stuff which is mentioned there, hidden between. One is that urban local bodies, once you graduate there, you can work with them. So usually what people do after they graduate, if they're not getting, they prepare for some exams or competitive exams, or they try to look for things, but they're sitting at home and not doing anything productive. This ties the two things up. There's a caring society, so you're actually contributing to your municipal corporation or your local body, and you're also getting skills, so that way you are getting skills, so maybe in a year's time you will get the job. There's also a linking that that 100 ranked, top ranked institution, you can take online courses. So the gap that is there today between academia and industry, there are a lot of nice ways hidden there by which you are trying to fill in that gap. So these are nice things that are there.
Yeah. I think there is one interesting thing that FM has mentioned, that wealth creators will be honored. And this is a tectonic shift from Nehruvian economy, where we'll see in movies that all the villains with their bit side locks and hookah are always trading tenders, and they are bad. Like, earning capital was considered bad in India. And now this term entrepreneur is coming up, and FM mentioning that wealth creation will be honored. I think that's a good tectonic shift in our mindset, which is marred by Nehruvian socialism.
Definitely, that's the view. Look, coming back to electric vehicle, the government has, you know, earmarked about 4,400 crore for daily pollution. How do you see it for electric vehicle?
So we need to again dig down approach on this. What exactly is there, and what kind of benefits are they providing? Definitely, Delhi government has talked about the subsidies and everything before going into the election session, and what effects it will have definitely need to be monitored. We have seen some good traction as far as electric vehicle is concerned over the past few months, or almost a year now, with a reduction in GST, a lot of budget going for electric transport, especially in bus and last mile connectivity. So those kind of effects we'll definitely see in the coming year, how it's going to affect the electric vehicle segment as a whole.
There was huge hope on Finance Minister as automotive industry is going to adopt BS6, and in June they are going to adopt a new safety norm. Both are going to increase the cost of acquisition of vehicles. Already the industry is really under huge pressure. Amit, how are you today?
I'm same as I was yesterday. So I don't see much of the difference between yesterday and today. You know, it's almost same. The questions remain same, and it's everything is same. Like nothing, no change. As per automobile dealer, I don't see any change in the demand generation.
We have seen over 200 dealerships have been closed down in the last few months. I would like to have your call on auto component space. Do you see any major change?
No major space, only one thing that which I've already mentioned, that semiconductor packaging, because right now we are dependent on China for the PCB structure, PCB electronic structure, and for the this semiconductor thing. Right now government is accepting this fact, and government is looking to boost the domestic manufacturing of these products. Now this is good, but otherwise I don't think much impact on the auto component industry.
See, the government has put again focus back on infrastructure. Though we compare 2019 and 2018, there has been almost 67% drop in terms of the NH awards. How do you see this with the current, you know, over 1 lakh crore being given to road and transport infrastructure. Also, how do you see this, especially the commercial vehicle, which has been going through one of the worst phases?
No, this is definitely positive. I think apart from agriculture, infrastructure spending, and also the effort in developing skill and education, I think they've been very positive. But again, I think infrastructure would help commercial vehicle if the economy does well. I think without economy doing much better, commercial vehicle will not have things to carry on those infrastructure. So while it is positive in some way, but it doesn't directly impact the automotive business.
So let's take their opinion on how do they rate the today's union budget speech on the scale of 10, 1 to 10, 10 being the highest. Gaurav?
I think 6 is the right call here.
What's your rating?
Yeah, I would say about 6, because it has done a couple of things positive, like agriculture, infrastructure, education, skill development, but not directly handling the current crisis which I think economy is doing.
What's your definitely rating? I agree with the 6 is the right rating.
What's yours? So I'll score it around 6.5 or so.
You're more positive. If I look at the whole entire budget, then it's 8, just the auto sector 6.
I think it's too early to comment. We have to go say the fine print. We just saw the 2-hour speech only, but I'll at least give 7-8 based on the prominence given to wealth creation.
So overall, if we see the announcement, is certainly 6.5, if we average, that's what the rating being given by the panel present here. But if I talk about the entire automotive value chain, whom I've been talking to since the budget was being rated, I think this is not very much in line with what the industry was expecting. This is probably one of the worst time for automotive industry, and even that wheel of economy seems to be stuck where it was yesterday. So we see that there is some announcement coming up in the next few, because finance minister has been very proactive in the last few months, and we have seen several press conferences happening. Hope she comes and makes some announcement that will certainly let the wheel of economy rolling. Thank you so much for watching ETAuto. Thank you.